about fireworks today.
I love watching fireworks. It's so beautiful.
Okay, well, I agree with you that they are very beautiful. But I went to Taipei 101 and watched the fireworks this year, and I'm never going back.
Why? But I also had a bad experience. But tell me why.
It was just too crowded, and it was so difficult to get home afterwards. I got home at like 3:30 in the morning.
You are right, because everyone wants to go to Taipei 101 and watch the fireworks, right?
Yeah. What's your bad story?
Well, you know, one year, it was like many, many years ago, me and my friends were thinking, okay, let's go to Taipei 101 and watch the fireworks, right? And it was great. And it's like, okay, I'll meet you there at maybe 11 p.m. But then when I finally got there, it was like so crowded, and I started calling my friends, and then the phone wouldn't go through.
Too many people.
Everybody is using their phone. So I couldn't contact my friends, and it was too crowded. So you know what ended up happening?
You had to do the countdown by yourself?
Yes, I countdown by myself. I was like in this place with like watching a bunch of people in different groups. They're like, Happy New Year! And I'm just like,
that is so
sad. Happy New Year, Karen.
Oh my goodness.
And then I just walked home by myself afterwards.
That's like the saddest story I've ever heard.
I know.
That is so sad.
That's why, if you want to go with your friends to watch fireworks at Taipei 101,
go together.
You have
Don't
to go
meet
together.
Them
you can't meet them there, okay?
All right, well, let's talk about fireworks in a moment.
All right.
For people the world over, the word fireworks brings up happy memories of light, noise, and celebrations. So just for the fun of it, here's a little history and a collection of interesting facts about fireworks. From firecrackers to fireworks. Firecrackers were invented in 10th century China. They were made from rolled sheets of paper and contained gunpowder and a fuse. The loud sound produced by firecrackers was used to drive out evil spirits, and it was also commonly heard when people celebrated birthdays and weddings.
Okay, Karen. Welcome everybody to Live Interactive English. This is Karen, and I am Shane.
That's right. And today we're looking at part one of In Celebration of Fireworks. That's right. Ooh, I love talking about fireworks.
Fireworks are fun.
That's right.
Okay, for people the world over, the word fireworks brings up happy memories of light, noise, and celebrations.
Definitely.
So for you, it does seem to make you pretty happy, unless you think about that terrible time you had in Taipei 101.
You mean counting down by myself?
Yeah.
Okay, you're right.
Doesn't sound like a very good celebration, actually.
Yes.
So just for the fun of it, here's a little history and a collection of interesting facts about fireworks.
That is wonderful. I love learning about the history of fireworks. And our first vocabulary is collection. When you collect different things and you really like something, you would like to have a collection of it. For example, if people would like to read comic books, and then they would probably collect many, many, many comic books at home, and they would have a collection of them. So it's like a number of the things that you really love. And some people really like paintings. Yeah. They can collect paintings, then they would have a collection of paintings.
I used to collect baseball cards.
Seriously?
Yeah. Well, I guess I still do collect them because I still have the collection. But I haven't collected any in many, many years.
But they're probably worth a lot of money right now.
I don't know. I should check.
In our example sentence today, it says, Tommy's comic collection is very valuable.
Okie dokie.
So probably your baseball cards too.
Might be valuable. I hope so.
Okay, and let's continue today's article. It says, from firecrackers to fireworks. Okay. Firecrackers were invented in 10th century China.
Whoa, that's a long time ago.
Exactly. I didn't know that. You know, firecracker first in China. Yeah. And they were made from rolled sheets of paper and contained gunpowder and a fuse.
And a fuse, wow. So gunpowder is a kind of powder that you put in a gun so that if you add a fire to it, basically, it will explode.
Yes, exactly.
Right? And when it explodes, if you have a gun, the explosion will make the bullet go out, right? Or if it's some other kind of thing, like a cannon.
Exactly, right? It will just explode,
right? There's a cannon, I think you do light a fuse. So what's a fuse?
So fuse, that line that you usually see, right?
Like a string or something, because
it takes time, right? So if you light it, if it blows up right away, then you would get hurt. So you would have that fuse that gives you that extra time.
To run away.
Exactly.
The loud sound produced by firecrackers was used to drive out evil spirits. And it was also commonly heard when people celebrated birthdays and weddings.
I didn't know about the evil spirits. I didn't know that it was, you know, what it was used for.
Yeah, that's the common reason, is to scare them away.
Mm-hmm.
And so a spirit basically is a ghost, right?
That's right. It's like someone who passes away and you believe that their spirit will go elsewhere.
Right. So sometimes we say a human has a spirit, right? Mm-hmm. But that is usually, we don't think of that it's going to be scary or something. You don't want to scare that away.
That's right.
So here, if you say a spirit and you want to scare it away, you're thinking that spirit might want to harm you or something,
right? So that's why you call it the evil spirit,
right? Right.
So something evil is like something bad.
So in our example sentence, they say, people say that an evil spirit appears in this room at night.
What? In this room?
In this room?
In this room?
I hope it's not like a hotel room or something. That's scary when you're gonna go stay in a hotel and you're doing some research. And you find out when you research the name, you will put in ABC Hotel. And then afterwards it says ghost or haunted. Yeah.
I think that's why a lot of people have the, you know, the tradition of knocking on the door and before they enter.
So tell them, hello ghost, I'm here.
I think that's to show respect. I don't know, a lot of people do that. I never tried, but I, you know.
I never understood this tradition.
Exactly.
Why are you just telling the ghost, hi,
I'm here. I'm gonna bother you for tonight and I'll leave tomorrow, please leave me alone.
Or maybe it's give them time to go hide or to leave.
Perhaps. I don't really know.
I don't know. Why don't we take a break and we can Google it?
Okay, sure. We'll see you guys back here soon.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny。同学们喜欢看烟火吗？我们这两天的课文是要简单介绍烟火的历史，还有一些有趣事实。那文中用到 a collection of interesting facts 来表达，这个 collection 它本身有收藏品、收集物的意思，可是在这边它是指一堆、一群，我们就常常用 a collection of 加名词来表达。好，那首先我们就来介绍鞭炮 firecrackers。鞭炮是在十世纪的中国发明的，那他们是用这个卷纸来制成，里面含有火药和引信。我们知道说鞭炮它会产生很大的声音，巨大声响，那最主要一开始它是用来驱逐邪灵，我们不是有听过年兽的故事吗？要吓走邪灵嘛。然后现在在婚礼啊、祝寿，或者是你听到这个开工啊、店铺开张，也常常都会听到鞭炮声。好，单字 spirit 它表示鬼魂、幽灵，也可以用来指心灵、灵魂。那么文中的 evil spirit 就是指邪灵、恶灵。Shane 老师说的这个 haunted， 我们来拼一下 H-A-U-N-T-E-D。Haunted 它是形容闹鬼的或是挥之不去的，那它的动词 haunt 可以用来表达像是鬼魂等等的出没，或是指不断的纠缠。好，刚刚说到这个火药引信，老师提到 cannon， C-A-N-N-O-N， cannon 就是大炮的意思哦。解剖课文中，
Chinese soldiers soon figured out a way to fire bombs at their enemies by attaching firecrackers to arrows. Later, these fireworks were turned into rockets that could be fired at enemies without the help of an arrow. This same technology is used in many fireworks shows today. The Italian Connection. Fireworks made their way to Europe in the 13th century, and they further evolved in Italy. The Italians were true masters of firework design.They were the first to create fireworks that exploded into creative shapes, and it was the Italians who added metal powders to fireworks to make a wider range of colors.
Welcome back, everybody. We're still learning about fireworks. That's right. Okay, so in the article it says Chinese soldiers soon figured out a way to fire bombs at their enemies by attaching firecrackers to arrows.
Ooh, that's kind of like the first like missile or something, right?
That's right.
That's really interesting.
Okay, so they're attaching firecrackers to arrows, but what are arrows?
So an arrow basically, I mean, it's like a stick or something like long, so it could be metal. And then attached to that, we will have something sharp.
That's right.
Like has a point, so it could be made of metal or stone if it's a long time ago. But the point is you want to injure or kill a person or animal, right?
Exactly. And usually you probably use a bow and arrow together and then to make it go really, really far. Right?
Yeah. So if you attach a firework to it, it will also explode.
That's right.
But that's kind of the idea of what a missile is, right?
You're right.
So it's like the first missile. That's so cool. So for example sentence, hundreds of arrows were shot over the castle's walls.
So usually when people are at war, where they're fighting with each other, a long time ago people would use bow and arrows.
And I remember seeing in movies where they will light the arrows on fire. So they're like fire arrows.
Exactly.
So it can help to make the place they're firing at, like the fort or the castle, catch on fire.
Exactly.
So then the people have to come out and then they get them.
So scary. Okay, and later these fireworks were turned into rockets that could be fired at enemies without the help of an arrow.
Right. It's like a rocket is kind of like a missile, right?
Exactly.
Okay. This same technology is used in many fireworks shows today. So we're using the same kind of technology, right?
But now when we're using it, you know, with fireworks, we're not really hurting anybody. We're basically just enjoying this celebration, and it's really nice too.
Yeah, we're just using the technology for peace and bringing people together.
And that's what we should do all the time, and not for war, right?
I think pretty much fireworks these days, at least, I think that's one difference. I think in China, or in Chinese countries, they are used for chasing away evil spirits, or sometimes, like, why do they do that when they're opening a business here? Why do they use firecrackers for...
I think it's supposed to bring good luck.
So that's good luck? Good luck or scare away the bad luck?
I'm not sure.
But
I know a lot of people do that, you're right. You know, every time they, you know, start a business, they always set out firecrackers too.
Yeah. Pretty much in America, the only time we use fireworks is for a celebration.
Exactly.
Like 4th of July or for the New Year. All right, let's learn about Italians. There's the Italian connection. Okay, so Italians are going to get involved now.
Okay.
Fireworks made their way to Europe in the 13th century, and they further evolved in Italy. Evolving, that just means that they're becoming more
advanced,
right?
And the Italians were true masters of firework design. They were the first to create fireworks that exploded into creative shapes. And it was the Italians who added metal powders to fireworks to make a wider range of colors.
Interesting, because we do think of Italians as being really good at creating very high quality things.
Art as well.
Yeah, or if you want some leather. If you know that this is leather was kind of made in a leather jacket was made in Italy, you'll think, whoa.
This
must be like the finest craftsmanship.
That's right. So they really worked hard in, you know, like thinking about different designs, about fireworks too, right? So now we have different colors and different shapes.
Yeah.
Wow.
So they brought it like to a new level.
Exactly.
And this level seems more of the kind of celebration thing, right? Because firecrackers explode, right? But they just, that's all they do, just make a loud noise.
That's right.
So explode means to blow up.
Yes.
And make a loud noise, and it's pretty dangerous. Our example sentence, cars only explode in action movies.
Really?
Have you ever seen a car explode in real life?
No, never. I guess you're right. Really? I thought they could explode in real life.
I think it's really, really, really difficult for a car to get all the way to the point where it will explode. But in movies, every car that catches fire explodes right away.
Because it looks really cool, right?
Yeah, and they want to be creative in these movies, right?
And that is our next vocabulary word. Creative is an adjective, and it's used to describe someone who is very, you know, like use their imagination, and then they're very creative. They think of different ideas, not just like the normal ideas that you would usually see. And then they try to use different ideas, put it together. People will go, wow, that's really, really cool. Like I never thought about that.
To use your imagination to make something.
Exactly. Right? And in our example sentence, it says, the company thought of a creative way to sell its new phone. So maybe their creative way is not the ones that we usually see. It's like, oh, this phone is really great. It's really convenient.
Right.
They use like a special way, and you never thought about it.
Right.
It's like,Okay, maybe I'll buy it.
So like the Italians making these fireworks, now they have colors and they can maybe have some different design when they explode.
Exactly.
This becomes more and more evolved.
Exactly. Like you can see stars and then you can see hearts, you can see circles. That is awesome.
I really want to go see, we could go on YouTube and check out a fireworks, maybe Taipei 101. We'll watch it from, from the comfort of our computer this time.
Okay, I think that's a good idea. And we'll see you guys next time.
Okay, take care.
好，那课文接着写到，中国士兵很快就想出一个把鞭炮绑在箭上来对敌人发射炸弹的方法。然后后来呢，这些烟火就被变成了火箭，不需要弓箭就能够对敌人发射了。而同样的技术也用在今天的许多烟火表演当中。好，单字 arrow 就是箭，弓箭的箭。那么 Shane 老师刚刚提到 missile，M-I-S-S-I-L-E，missile 则是指飞弹。而课文最后写到说，烟火在13世纪的时候一路传到了欧洲，然后在意大利进一步发展。意大利人啊，是真正的烟火设计大师，他们是最早制作出那些让烟火绽放成创意形状的人。他们把这个金属粉末加到烟火里面来创造出更多颜色，这样的做法也是意大利人在做的哦。那么 Shane 老师对于意大利的工艺技术和商品品质感到很赞叹，老师这时候用到 craftsmanship， 我们来拼一下C-R-A-F-T-S-M-A-N-S-H-I-P craftsmanship 表示工艺技术、技巧或是手艺。那么课文单字用到这个 explode 是动词，它表示爆炸、引爆。还有 creative 是形容有创造力的或是富有创意的。那这边三个重点，我们进入文法时间。好，来看第一个重点是 figure out， 它可以表达想出或是理解，像是想出新的事物。举例来说 ，We've already figured out a way to solve the problem， 我们已经想出一个解决问题的方法了。第二个重点是 fire 当动词可以表达发射、开火，常常会用 fire something at somebody， 或者是 fire something into somebody， 表示说朝某人开火发射什么什么。举例来说 ，The officer fired a shot。At the robber， 那位警员朝着抢匪开了一枪。第三个重点是分裂句的用法。分裂句呢，是把你原本句子要强调的部分，把它摆在 it is 和 that 之间，或是 it was 和 that 之间。那强调的部分可以是你原本句子里面的主词啊、受词、时间副词或是地方副词等等。接着我们再把你原本句子剩下的部分把它丢到 that 之后，句型就是 it is 或是 it was 加强调的部分加 that 再加句子其他部分。例如 ，The smell of fresh bread drew me to the bakery section。我们现在用分裂句来强调它的主词 ，the smell of fresh bread。这时候句子就会写作 ，It was the smell of fresh bread that drew me to the bakery section。正是新鲜刚烤好的面包，这个香味呢，把我吸引到烘焙区了。好，另外当分裂句要强调部分是人的话，你也可以把 that 改成 who。例如。It was Sarah who told him the secret, not me. 是 Sarah 把秘密告诉他的，不是我啦。好，那么以上是今天的讲解，同学们别走开，马上回来哦。
For people the world over, the word fireworks brings up happy memories of light, noise, and celebrations. So just for the fun of it, here's a little history and a collection of interesting facts about fireworks.From firecrackers to fireworks. Firecrackers were invented in 10th century China. They were made from rolled sheets of paper and contained gunpowder and a fuse. The loud sound produced by firecrackers was used to drive out evil spirits and it was also commonly heard when people celebrated birthdays and weddings. Chinese soldiers soon figured out a way to fire bombs at their enemies by attaching firecrackers to arrows. Later, these fireworks were turned into rockets that could be fired at enemies without the help of an arrow. This same technology is used in many fireworks shows today. The Italian Connection. Fireworks made their way to Europe in the 13th century, and they further evolved in Italy. The Italians were true masters of firework design. They were the first to create fireworks that exploded into creative shapes, and it was the Italians who added metal powders to fireworks to make a wider range of colors.
Hi everyone, I'm Steven.
And I'm Matt.
We're gonna play a game called Word Drop, where each of us has three words or phrases on these cards. We haven't looked at them yet. You haven't looked yet?
I haven't.
Okay. And then we're gonna try to work it into a conversation as casually as possible. So let's get started. I vote you to go first.
Okay.
Okay.
So, when I'm working, I need to think of you know, new subject matter, because I teach children, so I need to think of new games and new things we can do in the classroom. And, you know, it's really difficult, and sometimes I need to get, you know, when I'm trying to think of a new game or new activity for them, I need to get very creative.
I think it's really important to be a really good teacher. But sometimes, like, not all teachers are great. But the ones that are great, like, it makes you really want to go to class. Like, if a teacher is like, tomorrow we're gonna do like a lesson on animals, then I'll be like, oh my gosh, I'm about to explode with excitement. But not really explode, because that's kind of scary.
Yeah, I mean, I teach lessons on animals sometimes, and you know, I think it'd be really nice to take a class to the zoo to see the animals and to really show them, you know, the animals in real life, but I, you know, I'm having trouble trying to convince my boss, and I need to figure out how to do it.
Right, it is really difficult to get on field trips, but hopefully one day you'll be able to go to the zoo, and then when you get to the zoo, hopefully, like, you can teach the kids how to love these animals, how to cherish them, respect them, appreciate them. But make sure there aren't any weapons around, because you know how people usually take bows and arrows and they shoot these animals in the wild, like, or in the past? Don't do that. Don't give them any arrows.
Okay. I usually avoid giving my students weapons, and
that's good.
It's good to cherish things, and I have a lot of things that I cherish at home. They even have some old toys that I've had since I was young, and I have them as my collection.
Ooh, that's so nice to have a collection of lovely toys. You know what? I think that's really good that you still hold on to those, because those are great childhood memories. You know what? That's the spirit. Good for you.
Thanks.
Spirit.
Spirit, yeah.
I was supposed to do that. That's the spirit, boy.
See you next time.